bidirectional ping. Now, bidirectional ping is a feature, we can say it is an extension to the ping's sparse mode concept, which allows only shared tree inside your multicast domain. Like before we get into the details of this bidirectional ping, let's get back to the default sparse mode, how it is going to work. Like in the sparse mode, we configure something called rendezvous point RP, where every source has to register themselves with S-G entries. And if you have a receiver is going to send some join messages, probably, and all the downstream routers will maintain an entry called *G, where they want to receive the multicast traffic from any source for this particular group address. And then once they both register with the RP, RP is going to provide information about the source, and the receiver is going to use the shortest path to reach the source, and it's going to build something called source tree. So initially it goes via RP, which we call it as a shared tree. Later on, it's going to fall back to the source tree. That is the shortest path. It's going to calculate the shortest path from sender to the receiver. Now this short sparse mode default using the shortest path do not scale well when we have a lot of when you are running some applications where you have every source also a receiver. Like maybe you're using some video conferencing application, or where you have more senders as well as more receivers. Now in this kind of scenarios, where every receiver needs to join the shortest path for all the source trees in the multicast domain. So if you have more senders, more receivers, there are too many S-G entries, which is not going to scale well in the big size networks. It's going to increase the amount of multicast route status, that is your S-G entries. So to overcome these things, we can use something called bidirectional ping. Now, bidirectional ping is a feature which is designed for many-to-many applications, which is going to allow only shared tree, that is your *G entries, and it's going to ensure that it will never create a shortest path. It's not going to create any shortest path. So when the source sends the multicast, when the source is sending the multicast, it always go via RP, and the RP down to the receivers, and there is no shortest path created from source to receiver. So that's what bidirectional ping solves the issues of many-to-many applications, where it is going to use something called *G entries, and it will never fall back to the S-G entries. And all the traffic from the source and the receiver is going to always go via RP based on *G entries, and it will never fall back to the shortest path. So in this section, we are going to see much more in detail on how it's going to work. Now let's see how the bidirectional ping is going to work. Now the first step is we need to define, enable the bidirectional ping on all the routers, and we need to define what is the RP and what is the group range for which we need to enable the bidirectional ping. And if I do not define the group range, by default it is going to use for all class D addresses, or you can specifically define that the bidirectional ping should only work for 224.5.4.5. But for all the remaining groups, it has to use the shortest path. Now we can specifically define those things, but it's not really mandatory. Now the next thing is, once we define this bidirectional ping, it's simply going to stop all your S-G entries. It's going to stop the shortest path, and it's going to stop for the specific group range. If you don't define, it's going to do it for all the class D addresses. We'll see in short commands, configuration, like there's just one line command we need to enable on all the routers. We just need to say IP ping bidirectional enable. Once you add this command on all the routers, it's going to enable bidirectional ping from all the routers. And if you're configuring any RP, we need to configure on RP as well. If you're using static RP, we need to add the RP address along with this option at the end, bidirectional. Now if you're using auto RP method, probably you need to add this keyword in the last. Or if you're using the bootstrap router method, probably we need to add this keyword. Now the configuration is very simple and very straightforward. We just need to add this command on all the routers, and we need to tell the RP that it's going to run something called bidirectional ping. Now once we define the bidirectional ping for the RP as well as for the specific groups, now it's going to build *G entries towards the RP. Now once it builds the *G entries, the traffic flows from the source, it's going to flow towards the RP, and from the RP it's going to back to the receivers. So based on all the star comma g entries. Now that's the second step. Now here there is no PIM register messages. Now here, in general, if you just get back to the basics, parse mode implementation, the source router, the first hop router is going to send a register messages, and based on that register messages, the RP will come to know about the source and it's going to build some star comma g entries. Now in case of bidirectional PIM, we don't use source register procedure. Now every source connecting to the PIM directional mode can start sending the traffic at any time, and the packet floats towards the RP. And after reaching the RP, the packets will get dropped if there is no receiver. So let's say there's no receiver at all, there's no join messages, probably the packets will get dropped here. And in case if there are some receivers, the packets will be forwarded to the receivers via RP. Now here, in case of bidirectional PIM, there is no method to tell the source by the RP to stop sending the traffic even though there is no receiver. Now there is no more PIM register messages required here. The source will simply send out the traffic to the RP, and if you have a receiver, it will be forwarded to the receiver based on the star comma g entries. And if you don't have receivers, the packets will get dropped. And the final thing is the last step, loop prevention mechanism. How the loop prevention mechanism is going to be in bidirectional PIM. Now bidirectional PIM is going to use something called designated forwarder for loop prevention, which means there is no RPF checks. Now the first thing is, in bidirectional PIM, the routers are going to select any one router as a designated forwarder out of these two routers on every connected link, and other will be referred as non-designated forwarder. Now in these two links, any one will be the forwarder, other will be non-designated forwarder. Now the same thing happens with these two links, on these two links as well. So the router which is elected as a DF will be forwarding the multicast traffic. Now this designated forward elections are based on the best AD value. That's the first thing it is going to check. AD value towards the RP again. And if the advertisements are coming from the same routing protocol, probably the AD value will be the same. In that case, it is going to see the shortest metric to the RP. And if the metric is same due to some reason, then it is going to see the highest IP address of the particular interface. Now, based on these three conditions, it's going to decide the designated forwarder. And out of two routers or more than two routers connecting on the same segment, anyone will be forwarding the traffic based on these elections. Now every router is going to create star comma g entries, all the routers, towards the RP for each and every group. And it's going to point out the output interface based on the PIM join messages. Like here, this router is going to build a star comma g entries here. And if it is receiving any join messages, probably it is going to put this interface in the output interface list, where it is going to send out the multicast traffic on this interface. Now this is how the bidirectional PIM is going to work in general when you enable it. Now the configuration wise, it's going to be simple and straightforward. We just need to enable IP PIM bidirectional enable on all the routers. And I'm assuming that IP PIM's parse mode is already enabled here. And depending upon the type of the RP configuration we are using, if you're using static RP, then we need to add this command along with the RP. Now, if you're using auto RP, or if you're using bootstrap router. So let's get into the command line to verify the behavior of the PIM here, bidirectional mode.